states right now are grappling with the impact of the COVID-19, and one of them, of course, is the state of Telangana. Joining me now to talk about how the state of Telangana is dealing with this and how COVID-19 will impact people in the state finances, also companies in the state. It's an IT hub. I'm speaking now with KT Rama Rao, who is, of course, a minister in the state cabinet, son of the chief minister, KCR, and working president of the party that runs the state, the TRS. So, Mr. Rao, thank you for speaking with us here on ET Now. Welcome to the show. Let me begin by asking you what the biggest challenge as an administrator is at this point. Is it the lockdown of borders, and yet you see a large number of people still wanting to move across it? The problem of migrant laborers moving from point A to point B.
Firstly, thank you for having me. I think there are three facets to this whole challenge that Telangana, along with the world, is facing right now. See, the first facet is, of course, like you pointed out, ensuring containment through lockdown. And as directed by Government of India, our Honorable Chief Minister has taken the lead and has been leading from the front. And this lockdown, I would say, has been effective to about, say, 90-95%, but there is always scope for improvement. So containment remains a challenge. Containment remains concern. Now, secondly, also, if there are positive cases, how do you handle it? How do you have the adequate medical infrastructure? Do you have the equipment? Do you have the masks? Do you have the ventilators and all the infrastructure that goes into treatment and curative therapy? That also we are seized of. We've been procuring. We've been ensuring that adequate provisions are made. So we are also prepared. In terms of curative. We are preparing about 5 exclusive COVID hospitals. And the last part, I would say, the third facet, that all of us face is the fallout, the economic fallout of the whole economic and also the human angle with respect to the whole COVID epidemic. How to handle the migrant workers, how to handle, the daily wage workers, how do you ensure that, essentials are provided, etc. So our government is taken a very comprehensive view, and we have been working on all three fronts, led by the Honorable Chief Minister Sri KCR Garu. And I would say, so far, I think our efforts are, in the right direction.
Sure. But let me just come back to the issue of the large number of people in the informal sector who suddenly, after the lockdown, felt they had to, move across thousands of hundreds of kilometers in some cases. Do you think that states were caught unprepared, and all states, I'm not talking about just Telangana, because now you have seen states come up with relief camps and aid for these people who have set out on foot quite a few days ago?
Let me tell you something. In fact, Telangana state has woken up much before anybody else in the country had. In fact, about a week ago, our Honorable Chief Minister had asked me as the municipal minister to summon a meeting with all the contractors and all the builders, all the people engaged in the construction industry where typically all the migrant workers are engaged. We had a meeting about a week ago, and since then we've been running relief camps. So therefore you don't see the same sight that you see, say, in other states in the country with respect to migrant workers. You haven't been able to capture those in Telangana and Hyderabad, because we had already identified and we've already started providing essentials, including food and also medicine and other supplies to these migrant workers. The one thing that I think we all have to agree on is that this virus has literally broken down all barriers. There is no race, there is no religion, there is no geographical boundary, there is no national boundary, there is no state boundary per se. So therefore, it has breached all boundaries, and this is a problem that is confronting the entire humanity. So when we understand that, then we obviously will take cognizance of the seriousness of the issue, and therefore no government will actually say, somebody is a migrant worker versus a domicile. I think that is what was lacking. But now I believe all of us have, along with union government, all of us have come to a consensus, and each government is doing its own, best efforts.
The other big challenge which has emerged because of the lockdown, Mr. Rao, is the supply chain distribution, which has been, the supply chain has been completely disrupted. What has been the experience in Telangana, and how are you tackling that?
Samana, before I answer the question on supply chain and how to make sure that it sustains and continues without a hitch.
Yeah.
Let me also point out that this crisis has definitely exposed a lot of lacuna in our, I wouldn't just call it a lacuna, but also inadequacies with respect to what is being manufactured in India, what is being imported into India, what is affecting it, et cetera, et cetera. In fact, I had a conversation in February with the medical devices manufacturers, and many of them, in fact, as part of BioAsia, which was held in Hyderabad on February 17th and 18th, we had a long conversation with all the CEOs of the med devices industry, medical devices manufacturers. They had told me one thing very clearly. In fact, with respect to some medical devices, especially masks, gloves, etc., the basic surgical equipment, it is cheaper to import them than to manufacture them in India. So these are questions that confront us now. These are questions that we need to find answers for on a longer term or a medium term basis. I'm not talking about the short term right now, but there are certainly questions that have been popping up which need answers, which we need to find answers for. Now, going to your question about supply chain, I think every state has been challenged, with respect to the movement of goods and essentials. And yes, logistics have been affected initially, but after having overcome the initial hiccups and initial teething pains, I think by and large now things have stabilized. And with respect to medicines and essential food grains and food supplies, things are in place. And I do believe that the next 2 weeks you will see a lot of movement smoothly.
Okay, let's come to the medical question and the update on COVID-19 and what's happening in the state of Telangana. I was seeing a quote by the Chief Minister KCR saying that by 7th of April there would be no new cases of COVID-19 in the state. Where is that optimism coming from, and what really is the scenario right now?
Well, Tamanna, that has to be looked at in the context of his press meet. When he was speaking to the press, he had gotten the good news that 12 people who were prior positive have been cured and have tested negative in the latest set of tests. So that number effectively came down from 70 to 58 when he was speaking to the press day before yesterday. And he obviously was exuding optimism that since the last international air travelers have arrived on the 22nd of March and their quarantine would end on the 7th of April, and since there were no local spread, he was expressing optimism. He was exuding confidence that since the local spread has been contained, we would hopefully see a COVID-free state by the 7th of April. But unfortunately, with the Nizamuddin congregation that has been identified as a source of further spread, and that also affecting Telangana's numbers, we may have to wait a bit longer before we claim that we have complete control of COVID in our state.
All right, let me come to the economic question, Mr. Rao. Right now, several government, state governments, central governments have asked businesses to ensure that jobs are not cut, pay is not cut at this difficult time. But do you think that these businesses also need some kind of support from governments in terms of wage support at the very least, and especially for small and medium businesses?
The Reserve Bank of India and government of the Finance Ministry have announced some measures, which I believe will definitely bring a respite to the MSME sector, particularly with Government of India, in fact, volunteering and saying for any enterprise which has got less than 100 employees and more than 75 of them having a pay scale of above 15,000, they would even pay the EPF and ESI. Things definitely seem as concerning, but at the same time, this might give a bit of a respite. Now, we are also looking forward to working with the Government of India, especially Commerce Ministry and Finance Ministry, to see how we can actually evolve a joint strategy across the country and a common strategy so that across the country, all enterprises would receive similar benefits and similar relief.
All right, let me just ask you about the IT sector, because of course, there's a booming IT sector in Hyderabad. Do you think that this will be impacted by COVID-19? How is this space really moving forward?
Fortunately, in fact, as the pandemic broke out, we had a meeting with our ISPs and our telcos here. We asked them to enhance their network capacities. They've enhanced it by 30 to 40%. So we have a large IT presence, large IT ecosystem here. Majority of that is now currently working from home, And fortunately, like I said, with the enhanced capacity, their performance has not been affected. But yes, this has posed a new challenge for the industry and also for the government. In fact, the way we work has been challenged. So governments also have to think now, you know, and start thinking about digital governance, more e-governance, more mobile governance measures, as the enterprises would also have, you know, to plan for contingencies in such cases. Even the governments are now forced to rethink their strategy. So far, I would say that while there have been hiccups, they have stabilized now, and the IT industry is doing well. And I do hope going forward, you know, there won't be any service disruptions per se.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, K.T. Rama Rao, for speaking with us there, State Minister in Telangana, talking about the governance challenges that they're facing, which mirrors what a number of states are facing across India. We'll take a very short break at this point, but I promised you a blockbuster edition of the show, and that's what it is. After this break, I'm going to be joined by Baba Ramdev, co-founder of Patanjali, and we're going to ask him about the role that corporate India can play and whether he really believes that yoga can cure COVID-19. Stay tuned for that interview. We'll be right back.